Dear civil engineers, already we have completed our first part of Autodesk structural analysis. I mean Autodesk robot structural analysis professionals complete building design tutorial series. So in this lecture I'm just going to show that how we'll create a screw level and how we'll define a column beam slab reset. Okay, so first of all, to create a screw level, I'll just click here. A structure, a stories, I'll click here. Now there are two options. One, define graphically. So if you use that option, then it's up to you. But I will always use that option, define manually. So this is a best way to define. Then number of a story, that will be one, and height. So first of all, I will define our, if you see here, already they have a story. Okay, so I'll select that and I'll delete that first. Then that is one, and here you can define a story one, or you can define as per your requirement. So I'll use a story one to like that, and I'll change that. So after that, our first story, as I'm using G+5 story structure design, then it will be 6 feet. Okay, it will be 6 feet, just 6 feet, and simply click here add. So here we have created that, but its name showing story one, but I'll just give it, I'll change its name, then I'll double click and just see, you will get option like that and change its name like CF. Okay, so ground floor, then enter, and then okay. After that, I'll change its name to here our next story, that will be what will the height actually. Okay, what will the height here, I'll just give height will be 10, and that will be 1, then click here add. Okay, so you can see here, this is your GF ground floor level at 6 feet above, okay, top level. And this is 16 feet above, like that. So this is story one. Now, as I'm using G+5 story, the 4 story structure, so I'll just take another 3 here for 10, then I'll click add. Just see 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. It's have created. So story 1, 2, 3, 4, story have created. Now I'll take another story, that will be 1 for row. I'll just double click to change it. Okay, I have to change that. Okay, but before that, I can take here a 8 feet story for our terrace. So I'll just click add. Okay, so here, if I double click, then it will change. Then I'll just give a rope level, and okay, and for datum, okay. So for datum, you have to click double. I mean, you have to press double click of your mouse. Then simply I'll just give a terrace. So I'll use name here terrace. Then okay, okay. So just see, I have defined all of our story level. Then I'll simply click here, apply. When it's okay, I'll just close. And if I want to show it, just see base, then ground floor, story 1, 2, 3, 4, row, and terrace. Clear. So when it's done, now I'll just go to plan and I'll go here. So here, first of all, I'll just go for beam. So I'll click here, and if you see just here a section available, so from here I'll just go here in that option, and from here I'll select Rcc beam like that. So here, what is the level? So I'll just give its level is grade beam. And I'll consider our grade beam will be 12 into 15 inch. That will be the size of our grid beam. So I just go here. So what will the B? That will be 12, and our height will be 15. Clear? And they have many options. Section, you can select section. There are many options available. And if you want to change color, then you can change it. So if I consider that color like that for our beam, it will be. So after that, click here add. Okay. And I'll take another beam, floor beam, and that will be 10 into 15. On will be 10 into 15, so I'll just give here 10 into 15. I'll click add, and another will be 10 into 18. If we need, then that will be 10 into 18. Like that, then click add, and another will be stranger beam for our staircase, so that will be 10 into 15. 10 into 15, and I'll click add. After that, I'll click close. And if I use Rcc beam, see the beam I have. Defined that are available here, floor beam, here another floor beam, G beam, S beam. So all types of beam are available here. What I have defined. When it's done, I'll just click close. Okay. Now I'll just go here for column, and simply I'll go here. Okay, and I'll select Rcc column, and they have many types of column. Actually, you can see many types of column that are available. So I'll use rectangular column, and from here I'll just give its name C1, and its size will be 12 into 12 inch, and that will be 12 into 12. Okay. And if you need to use reduction formula, then you can use that. So I'll not use that at this moment. I'll click add. Again, I'll take another 12 into 15. Here, that will be 12 into 15. That I'll click add. And another I'll consider 12 into 18. And that will be 12 into 18. Add, and another I'll consider 15 into 18. 15 into 18, and then click add. So it's done. And if you need, you can change the take any kinds of beam or anything. So if you need to change that materials, then also you can change from here. Okay, so they have different types of materials with respect to its compressive strength. Then I'll click plus. So when you go Rcc column, just see here what types of column we have different data available. Then I'll close. After that, here I'll just go floors, and from here I'll go here, and I'll I'll just define floor. When I'll go for work, then I'll just get floor. It will be better. Okay, I'll define floor instantly. Or if you need to, they have two options: homogeneous and or orthogeneous. Okay, so if you want to define like that, then you can do that. So I'll use the steps of slab on beam. Okay, so our value is constant. So what will be the value? Our value will be 5 inch. 5 inch, and here I can change its name T5, and color. So I can use this type of color. So when it's done, simply click add and close. When it will come here, just see here the option available, and they have another option, model. Then click here, and what you want to use, shell or anything finite element type, that will be shell. I'll use shell. Okay, so if you use no finite, then you can use that, and that will be shell. And what will be the slab type, that will be two-way. Then add or now click here, close. So they have another way, shell, deck slab on a curtain wall. So you can define by clicking here, you can change the name. Okay, so this option is available, no need to change anything from here. So I'll close. I'll also close it. So it's done. Now in our next lecture, okay, in our next lecture, I'll show you that how we go for our next drawing. So in our next lecture, I'll show you that how we'll create our model and how we'll apply load on it. So thank you very much, sister. Yes, to connect with the next video. And on the previous all lectures, playlist are given in description. So I'll request you, if you want to see, then you can see that. So thank you very much, sister. Yes, to connect with the next video.